a lot of exciting announcements, but I think that how Google moves search forward, integrates artificial intelligence into how the consumer interacts with search, that's what we've all been interested in. What is the big picture here? What is it that Google announced today around the next generation of search?
Sure, so we're looking to continue our journey on making search more natural and intuitive. This has been something we've always been focused on. Just how do we make it as easy as asking a friend for information with the wealth of information on the web? And so today we're talking about how we brought generative AI combined with search to bring out the best, to really help you along your journey in new ways.
What's different? If I sit at my computer and I search for where can I go and see whales off the coast of San Francisco? If I use the AI powered version, what's different for me as the consumer or the user?
Yeah, so there's two things you'll see. The first is that you'll get an AI powered snapshot that pulls information across and helps summarize it in a more easy to understand way. The information you might have would be on the web, but it might be across many, many sources. And so now it's easier to pull it together. The second thing is you'll be able to ask follow-ups. People often come and they ask a question and then they refine their question, but they have to pretty much start over. And now you'll just be able to ask a natural question like you would a normal person and have the same sense of context that you would have in a conversation.
Google was cautious in how it rolled out Bard to consumers globally. Now you're announcing that it's available to everyone, no longer a waitlist, but how will you make access to this next-gen search available to the public around the world?
Yeah, so with search, we're taking a similar thoughtful approach in rolling it out. It'll be available in US English through Search Labs, a new capability, a place to go for more exploratory features, places that are more cutting edge. So you'll be able, if on the Google app or on Chrome desktop, to be opt into what we call the little beaker. There'll be a symbol at the top. You opt in there, and then you'll be able to opt into the experience.
How are you going to make sure that the AI generated response or return on a query is safe for the user?
Great question. So we take a number of steps to try and increase the factuality of the information. The first that we do is we train our models to actually understand what is the information on the web that corroborates it, that backs up the information. And if we can't corroborate it, then we will not output it.
As in you just won't show it
just won't
to
show,
the user.
Okay?
Yes.
We won't show a piece of information. And if we think a particular query is unsafe, it's harmful, then we will also not provide an AI-powered snapshot. We do a lot of rigorous training and evaluation on it to really understand how does it go. That's something search has always done, but we're paying particular attention in the case of our generative AI experiences. But you know, we will obviously make mistakes, and so we have options for users to provide feedback, to get the model, and we're setting expectations with Search Labs and with the UI that this is experimental and a work in progress.
You just touched on it, but are there certain areas, subject matter, where you won't apply artificial intelligence to a result that's returned? I'm thinking of, you know, actually some quite sinister or sensitive, you know, corners of the internet, but where is it not appropriate to apply AI in search?
Yeah, so for the generative AI experiences, one example would be, let's say you search for Tylenol dosage for a three-year-old.
Okay.
Right? We do not think that it is useful for us to do this, and so we will not respond. We'll just give you the web results. There are great web results up there to read. We should not do that. Another example, if you're searching for self-harm, that's not something we should do. We'll instead give you hotlines and prevention techniques on that.
The core search business at Google, Google Search, is mega. It's everything. You have been at this company since 2003, focused on AI. What's changed? What has your day-to-day change been? What has the technological change been in the time you've been at this company?
So it's really been absolutely tremendous. If you think about it years ago, now you take for granted that you can do voice search. Once upon a time, that was viewed as pretty much, there were so many error rates every time you do this. Then we could get to the point where you could take with a snapshot with your camera and understand what the flower is or what that shopping bag is with someone else. That was something that we didn't think was possible. And now generative AI is the latest evolution. It's just tremendous what the technology is enabling.
What is the North Star for you for Google Search?
Yeah.
You know, I think we're getting used to this idea that Google Search will change. But for you, I mean, where are you in its evolution? What do you see in its future?
So the North Star for us is always, how do we help people with their information needs? One of the things we've seen over time is as technology gets easier and easier, people ask more questions. They always had those questions. Let's say you walk by the flower. You might wonder what it was, but it was too much work. Now if you can take a snapshot and understand what it is, then you ask. And so we think there's really a tremendous amount of information need that people have. People are very curious and fundamentally interested in the world. And as we make Google search easier and easier for people, we think we can continue to help people on those journeys.
The final question is around the user knowing that what they are engaging with is either AI generated or generative AI has been involved in the process. I think on stage there was a lot of discussion around notifying users if an image is linked to AI generated content. How does that apply to search? I mean, how clearly do you point out that something was brought to the user's attention or returned as a query with the use of a generative AI tool?
Yeah, so in the new search experience, the generative AI snapshot is labeled generative AI is experimental. It has that at the top. Also, people who are opting in are doing so via search labs, in which we give additional information when you're choosing to do so about it.